Hello and welcome to Black Ice Studios. Today we're going to go over how to make an EC2 instance in the Amazon Cloud Service. Hi, I'm your host Casey, and today we're going to show you how to make an EC2 instance in the Amazon Cloud Services. Right now we're going to go to My Account, and we're going to go ahead and click Log into the console. I'm going to log in real quick. So we can see here that my name's up in the top right corner, and also the region that I'm in. I'm in North Virginia. There's a lot of different regions here. In the United States, there's about four of them. Now keep in mind that you won't be able to do anything cross-region, only cross-zone in the Amazon AWS. So we're going to click Services, and we're going to click EC2 Instances. I'm going to click Launch Instance. Okay, so this is basically your Amazon Machine Images. It's what you can create an image of a server off of. This is just a quick start here. It has a couple of them, Linux, SUSE Linux, a lot of Microsoft products. Keep in mind that if you get anything that has a license behind it, it will cost you extra for that license per hour. So you'll want to look into that before you launch anything licensed. That'd be Red Hat or Windows would obviously be licensed. So I'm going to go down here and click AWS Marketplace. Now this is where you can actually buy images. People will produce images, you can buy it. Here's the community AMIs. Anybody can make an AMI here. So I'm just going to see if there's a CentOS 7 out there that somebody's made. A lot of these are actually made by companies such as Rackspace and CentOS and Red Hat themselves, but it doesn't look like there's any CentOS 7 here. I'm seeing mainly 5.4, 5.5, no real sevens. So. I think I'm going to go back to the marketplace. Even though they can sell them here, a lot of them cost zero, 0.00, so they don't cost anything. Okay, so here's a CentOS 7. That's exactly what we want. And it's updates with HVM. Now, there's two types of instances. There's HVMs and PVs, and we won't get too deep into it. It's basically how they boot. You're going to want to do HVMs. Don't worry about PVs. That's what everything is and what everything's going to on Amazon. So unless you have a real need for a specific boot kernel, I just stick with the HVMs. I'm just kind of scanning here, seeing if there's any other one I would rather have than the top image there of CentOS 7. But I think I'm going to go with that one because it is actually made by CentOS. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. All right, now we're going to select our tier here. Now, this will obviously depend on how much a CPU and how much memory you have, but we're just going to select the T2 Micro for this case. And it'll also depend on how much you get charged. We just want one instance. Now, this networking, subnetworking, we're not going to worry about it too much because over in our next video, we're going to go over all this stuff. So I'm just going to select my East region that I've got here. And my subnet, I'm just going to select my East Region 1. Now, I'm going to not have it assign a public IP. You can have it assign one, but for now, I'm not going to do one for this video. It's not needed. When it shuts down, I'm just going to have it stop instead of terminating. You can protect against accidental termination as well. And you can enable CloudWatch, which gives you more detailed monitoring of your server. But we're not going to do those. So now this is basically how you're going to host it. If you're going to do shared, dedicated, or dedicated hosted, you're always going to want to do shared if you're doing on-demand. Dedicated hosted really isn't the benefit of the cloud, and dedicated is more for cost savings, but you have to pay a lump sum up front. So you're going to want to go shared on this. Now it's going to make us an interface here, ETHO0, which is going to be a private IP. There's also this additional details. It's just some kind of user data you can put in there. There's nothing really to do there. We're going to go to add storage now. Now storage, we're just going to give it 8 gigs. That's enough to install. There's a general purpose SSDs, provisioned IOPS SSDs, and magnetic. Your provisioned IOPS cost the most. Magnetic's the cheapest. We're going to tell it to delete on terminated. We're going to just say magnetic for now, that's fine, since we don't really care. Normally you want to do generalized SSDs. It's the best bang for your buck. Now, as it shows here, this is not encrypted. You actually have to launch off an encrypted snapshot to be able to do encryption. So if you're gonna do encryption, just make sure that you find an encrypted snapshot. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and add a tag. Tags are now useful for keeping track of where your money's going, right? You can kind of break up things by tags. So I'm just gonna put YouTube toots here. So we can see that that's what this was used for. If I put this name on everything and I could pair it to something else, but I'll be able to track where my money's going with that. Okay, the security groups here, we're just gonna use an existing one. There's always a default one. You can make yourself a new default or other ones. I'd recommend making some security groups, and we're gonna go over that in the next video. But for now, you can just select the default. It just allows all traffic currently in from anywhere, but you'll wanna lock that down a lot more. Now, when we hit go ahead to the next step, it does say there that we should be on a generalized SSD because the magnetic's slow, unless you have a real no need for any speed. I'd go with the generalized SSD. The magnetic's just a little slower and will take longer to boot from. So it's just gonna give us a review here. We're gonna say launch. We're gonna choose a key pair. I have an existing key pair that I'm gonna go ahead and select. You can make one if you don't have one. Now, you have to acknowledge that you won't have access to this instance if you don't have the key pair. They only give it to you once. If you don't have it, you pretty much have to rip down the box and rebuild it. There's no way for you to get into it. All right, so the instance has launched. It said that our instance is now launching. It'll say to notify us of estimated charges later. So we can see there that the YouTube toots is pending and it is standing itself up. So that's pretty much it. We're gonna go over next time how to do all the networking and what all the different networking pieces mean. Again, I'm your host Casey and thank you for watching this video. We hope you liked this video. If you did, please share, like, or comment on this video. Also, please comment on what you'd like to see from us next. You can keep up to date with our tutorials by either subscribing on YouTube, following us on Facebook, Twitter, or LinkedIn, or email us your comments and/or questions.